take a look at Eric Clapton's Bell Bottom Blues. Song's in the key of C. I'll play through the intro and then we'll begin breaking it down. Into a C grip, 2nd fret A, 3rd fret A, open D, hammer on to 2nd fret D. So I'm arpeggiating a C chord. Next chord we're going to is an E7, 1st fret G, 2nd fret A, to an A minor, 1st fret B, 2nd fret D and G, and then to a C7. To C chord, 1st fret B, 2nd fret D, 3rd fret A, pinky on the 3rd fret G string. I'm going to arpeggiate all those chords, and then from then on, I just hear strumming, and pretty much strumming through the rest of the song. So arpeggiating through those first four grips. Something like that. Pick up and strum an F grip. Then I'm getting, barring the first fret of the E and B with my first finger, 2nd fret G with my 2nd finger, ring finger on the A string 3, D string 3 with pinky, and thumb getting the F in the bottom. And just taking that up 2 frets to a G. So all that together. So F to G, back to F, and then this G7. 2nd fret A with my 2nd finger, 3rd fret D with my ring finger, pinky on the 3rd fret B, and 1st fret of the E string with my 1st finger. Really nice sounding G7 chord. All that together. On into the verse. Takes us to the chorus. Just another idea while we're playing the verse. The vocals are coming in here. I might kind of walk up from that G7. Just to kind of add a little something in that space there. So it'll be C. Something like that. Just walking up. Just an idea. There's sort of a signature lick there that we might as well go ahead and tackle. It's basically just a little triad in the F shape. 13th fret E and B. 14th fret G. Just right down. And then 10th fret B, 10th fret E, and then landing on 12th fret G. Sort of one way to play that. That lick occurs a lot. Just 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You could play it here. 14G, 15B, 12G. Or however you like that. So let's play through the verse, then go on into the chorus. We kind of move to an A, tonal center. Just starting with a, first position A, second fret of D, G, and B. What's happening now is we're going to walk the bass line down, and watching Clapton play it, he goes to this chord next, which is basically a C grip, just moved up, and then adding a bar on the fourth fret. So I'm barring across all strings on 4, 5th fret of B, 6th fret of D, and then 7th fret of E, or the A string. Kind of emphasizing the bottom 4 strings, making sure I get that bass note. To an F sharp minor, barring across the 2nd fret. And then, of all strings, 4th fret, A and D. Then to regular D and E. So that would be... Another grip to replace this that I would use myself would be this. It's an A with a, actually it's an E with a G sharp bass, which is what this is. 2nd fret D, 4th fret low E, 4th fret G string, muting the A string. Then to the F sharp minor, to the D and the E. Show you both those options, and you can kind of hear them. One more time. That one. Second option. And then the last voicing I'll show you would be maybe for a second guitar part. I'm getting 7th fret A, or D string rather, 6th fret G, moving down to this G sharp in the bottom, 6th fret of the D string, 4th fret of the G string. Moving that down 2 frets to the F sharp and A, 4 and 2, then, so that would sound like, against this maybe. Moving on. So the second half of that chorus, just an A grip to an A major 7. Moving my first finger down to the first fret of the G string. Pulling it out all together, giving me an A7 chord. D to E, then again. Then back to the verse with an F, G7. Another voicing of that second half of the chorus could be here. 5th fret B, 6th fret G, 7th fret D. Then I'm walking that note down. So I'm getting kind of an A minor type grip. 5th fret B, 6th fret D and G. And then 5th fret D and B, 6th fret G. All those kind of against an open A and high E string. The D again, put that whole chorus section and using some of those different voicings so you can hear them. About covers what is a great song, both on electric and acoustic. Thanks for watching.